24 HRS after FBI puts hush order on Vegas investigation info. Two more witnesses found dead. Early in October, Stephen Paddock opened fire at a country music festival in Las Vegas, Nevada that killed 58 people and injured over 500 more. Stephen Paddock's motive still has not been discovered, but that has not stopped internet sleuths from asking questions surrounding that evening, since law enforcement has been less than forthcoming. For instance, following the deadly shooting, many survivors claimed that there were multiple shooters that night despite the mainstream media's narrative that there was only one. Then, to add even more suspicion to that already horrifying evening, over the last couple weeks, several survivors have turned up dead, and the body count just rose by two more. The American people and the victims of the Las Vegas shooting deserve answers, but it appears that the FBI is not willing to give them. It has been nearly a month since the worst mass shooting in U.S. history occurred, and we are no closer to the truth than we were that fateful October night. Right after the shooting, law enforcement officials were updating the public on almost an hourly basis, but now there is barely an update. So, when the FBI announced that they would not be releasing any new information, stating it just did not matter anymore, it raised a few eyebrows, and it was not only independent thinkers. The Las Vegas Review-Journal noticed investigators being tight-lipped and reported on the silence just a few days ago. 58 people killed. More than 500 injured. And yet, nearly a month after the Las Vegas Strip experienced the worst mass shooting in modern American history, local and federal authorities are refusing to fill in the blanks. So, what are they afraid of the American people finding out? Well, it could be that many survivors of this shooting have been found dead, and what is even more disturbing is that these individuals question the official government story. Over the last several weeks, people who attended that Las Vegas country music festival have been turning up dead, and in some instances very violent deaths. Prissy Holly from Freedom Daily reported earlier this month on the strange death of 26-year-old Kimberly Succomill. Succomill attended the concert that night and died shortly afterward in her sleep, but that is just the beginning of the mystery. Succomill posted on social media soon after the attack that she spoke to several survivors who claimed that there were multiple shooters and not just one like the mainstream media reported. "Every single survivor I have talked to also remembers multiple shooters, and at least one from the ground. Why aren't we being taken more seriously? Tons of things don't add up," she wrote on Facebook, according to Rael Fremacy. With authorities and possibly top-level government agents now participating in an active cover-up, just how frantic and determined are these liars going to be at stopping the truth from coming out? Would they actually kill Americans in order to bury the truth about Las Vegas? According to breaking reports, it sure appears to look that way. Up until Kimberly Succomill was found mysteriously dead in her home on Wednesday in the early morning hours, the 28-year-old was very vocal in her assertion that there were multiple gunmen involved in the shooting. She had spoken to multiple news agencies about the truth of what happened that night, and was determined to not let the trail of evidence run cold. Michelle Flores, another survivor of that horrific night, also escaped certain death just days after the shooting. Flores, 51, had been outside of the Route 91 Harvest Festival in Las Vegas, watching the performers play when the shooting took place. By the grace of God, she survived the hail of gunfire only to be running for her life when her house caught fire later that week. Now, Dennis and Lorraine Carver, also survivors of the Las Vegas shooting, have died after their car exploded less than a mile from their home. The couple were married for 15 years and went to the concert to enjoy some of their favorite music artists together. When the gunfire began at the show, Dennis threw himself over his wife's body, Lorraine, to protect her from the hail of bullets. Dennis and Lorraine Carver are the latest in an increasing number of Las Vegas massacre survivors to die in suspicious circumstances or disappear in the weeks following the shooting. Disturbingly, the dead witnesses all have one thing in common: they all provided information that calls the official narrative into question, and they were all ignored by law enforcement and mainstream media. Yesterday we reported the death of Danny Contreras, another Las Vegas local who had been contradicting the official narrative that only one shooter fired on the Route 91 Harvest Festival crowd. Mr. Contreras tweeted the day after the attacks saying he was lucky to be alive after he was chased by two gunmen. His tweet was retweeted hundreds of times. Feeling lucky to be alive. Can't believe I got out of concert alive. Two men chasing me with guns. Not everyone's sulky. Early in October, Stephen Paddock opened fire at a country music festival in Las Vegas, Nevada that killed 58 people and injured over 500 more. Stephen Paddock's motive still has not been discovered, but that has not stopped internet sleuths from asking questions surrounding that evening since law enforcement has been less than forthcoming. For instance, following the deadly shooting, many survivors claimed that there were multiple shooters that night despite the mainstream media's narrative that there was only one. Then, to add even more suspicion to that already horrifying evening, over the last couple weeks, several survivors have turned up dead, and the body count just rose by two more. The American people and the victims of the Las Vegas shooting deserve answers, but it appears that the FBI is not willing to give them. It has been nearly a month since the worst mass shooting in U.S. history occurred, and we are no closer to the truth than we were that fateful October night. Right after the shooting, law enforcement officials were updating the public on almost an hourly basis, but now there is barely an update. So, when the FBI announced that they would not be releasing any new information stating it just did not matter anymore, it raised a few eyebrows, and it was not only independent thinkers. The Las Vegas Review-Journal noticed investigators being tight-lipped and reported on the silence just a few days ago. 58 people killed. More than 500 injured. And yet, nearly a month after the Las Vegas Strip experienced the worst mass shooting in modern American history, local and federal authorities are refusing to fill in the blanks. So, what are they afraid of the American people finding out? Well, it could be that many survivors of this shooting have been found dead, and what is even more disturbing is that these individuals question the official government story. Over the last several weeks, people who attended that Las Vegas country music festival have been turning up dead and in some instances very violent deaths. Prissy Holly from Freedom Daily reported earlier this month on the strange death of 26-year-old Kimberly Succomill. Succomill attended the concert that night and died shortly afterward in her sleep, but that is just the beginning of the mystery. Succomill posted on social media soon after the attack that she spoke to several survivors who claimed that there were multiple shooters and not just one like the mainstream media reported. Kimberly Succomill. Every single survivor I have talked to also remembers multiple shooters, and at least one from the ground. Why aren't we being taken more seriously? Tons of things don't add up, she wrote on Facebook, according to Rael Fremacy. Here is more from Freedom Daily. With authorities and possibly top-level government agents now participating in an active cover-up, just how frantic and determined are these liars going to be at stopping the truth from coming out? Would they actually kill Americans in order to bury the truth about Las Vegas? According to breaking reports, it sure appears to look that way. Up until Kimberly Succomill was found mysteriously dead in her home on Wednesday in the early morning hours, the 28-year-old was very vocal in her assertion that there were multiple gunmen involved in the shooting. She had spoken to multiple news agencies about the truth of what happened that night, and was determined to not let the trail of evidence run cold. Michelle Flores, another survivor of that horrific night, also escaped certain death just days after the shooting. Flores, 51, had been outside of the Route 91 Harvest Festival in Las Vegas, watching the performers play when the shooting took place. By the grace of God, she survived the hail of gunfire only to be running for her life when her house caught fire later that week. Michelle Flores. Now, Dennis, and Lorraine Carver, also survivors of the Las Vegas shooting, have died after their car exploded less than a mile from their home. The couple were married for 15 years and went to the concert to enjoy some of their favorite music artists together. When the gunfire began at the show, Dennis threw himself over his wife's body, Lorraine, to protect her from the hail of bullets. Dennis and Lorraine Carver survived the Las Vegas shooting only to have their car explode less than a mile from their home. However, while their death is a tragedy, it does take a strange turn considering that there are reports that the couple questioned the shooting. Here is more from your newswire. Dennis and Lorraine Carver are the latest in an increasing number of Las Vegas massacre survivors to die in suspicious circumstances or disappear in the weeks following the shooting. Disturbingly, the dead witnesses all have one thing in common: they all provided information that calls the official narrative into question, and they were all ignored by law enforcement and mainstream media. Yesterday we reported the death of Danny Contreras, another Las Vegas local who had been contradicting the official narrative that only one shooter fired on the Route 91 Harvest Festival crowd. Mr. Contreras tweeted the day after the attacks saying he was lucky to be alive after he was chased by two gunmen. His tweet was retweeted hundreds of times. Feeling lucky to be alive. Can't believe I got out of concert alive. Two men chasing me with guns. Not everyone's sulky. All of this cannot be brushed off as a mere coincidence. There are numerous survivor stories that state there were multiple shooters that night and videos taken by people on the ground that show gunfire in other hotels and casinos in the area. Why is the mainstream media still insisting there was one shooter when survivors of the shooting are saying something different? Also, why is law enforcement not coming forward with any new information about the motive of this horrific shooting?